Hi there, today on Typical Books, there are some new horror books out for late July. Now, I know I already did one of these videos not long ago, after not doing them as regularly, but there's a lot more books out, and there's one I've been waiting for on this list. I just love the cover, I love the story, I like a lot about it, and we've got some really cool artwork. But yeah, I'm trying to not do too long of these videos, and I don't like waiting as far as my volunteer job with the Horror Writers Association, leaving too many in the queue. I like to get them posted to the site and ready for the newsletter as they come in chunks of about six. So we have, I don't know, nine or something here today to talk about, because they came in sort of a bouquet of fresh July flowers, if you will. So without any more time to waste, here are some new books coming out from Horror Writers Association authors. Now, this one elicits a little imagination with this cover. It kind of reminds me of the book For Rye that I just covered, and some sort of fairy tale. I don't know, it looks cool. Beyond the Rail and Other Nightmares by Ichabod Ebenezer. And if you want some fun, go on over to Ichabod Ebenezer's website. He's got a really good website for an author site, and it's out already. 13 Tales of Horror and Dark Fiction. Within these pages, you'll find ghosts, werewolves, and zombies, but in stories you've never heard before. You'll also find cursed items, ancient gods, intelligent plants, and unspeakable acts. From steampunk London to Wild West Montana to the dark web. So yeah, this strikes my fancy, and I think there's something here for every horror author, and it's just a very fun and liltingly read summary, so that speaks to the rest of the book in my mind. The next one, I'm not going to read the summary, unfortunately, because it was provided by and large as quotes, and I'm not a theater kid, I'm no actress. So I just don't have the heart to read this out because it would feel awkward for me. But get a load of that cover, Chronicles of the Skullmask. I love this cover and it sounds compelling. This is the sort of thing like The Mask or like Devil Man or something that really does strike my interest. Although I just don't have the guts to read the synopsis. It's by Teel, James Glenn, out by Bold Venture Press, and it is out already. Six Adventures of the Skull Mask and the Various People Who Adopt Its Powers to Avenge Others, or Often Themselves. So it is a shared universe and collection, I suppose. So these six stories must weave together. I'm very intrigued. I am the Skull Mask, wear me if you dare. And that is as much of the lengthy quotes from the Skull Mask that I have the daring to read, because I'm no actress and I don't want to ruin this. Yeah, definitely check it out. Chronicles of the Skull Mask. Next is Sisters in Arms by Erica Ruppert. This is from Trepidatio Publishing. This is an imprint of JournalStone Publishing, and it is out just now. Michelle de la Fortuna's research brought her back to the lonely Massachusetts coast, to the house where the reclusive Sisters of Providence. For more than 60 years, the sisters have stood watch here, first against the pandemic that devastated their town, and then against an insidious threat from the depths of the sea. I really like this idea, and there is a pandemic thread here. There's a couple books that mention this in this clutch of books, but yeah, this sounds really cool, actually. And this next one, I didn't know what to make of it at first, but I like the cover, and it's a pandemic book. Absolute Unit by Nick Kolakowski. This is from Crystal Lake Publishing, and it is out this week. Bill is a nobody, a health inspector not above taking a few dollars to overlook a restaurant's mouse problem, and hated by nearly everyone. His nephew isn't much better and probably the worst con artist on the East Coast, but today, these two losers have become the most important people in the world, harboring a sentient parasite with a sarcastic sense of humor and a ravenous appetite. Seems to me that it might be something like Parasite, that anime. It's one of my favorites. Who knows? This sounds, yeah, especially when it's infecting two losers. So it's not a school kid or a high school student or a star track athlete. Yeah, two losers. Absolute Units, I am assuming. But yeah, Absolute Unit. Next, we have Queen of Teeth by Hailey Piper. Strangehouse Books puts this out, and it comes out in a week. Within 48 hours, Yaya Belancourt will go from discovering teeth between her thighs to being hunted by one of the most powerful corporations in America. A situation worsened when Yaya's condition sprouts horns, tentacles, and a mind of its own. People have even said that some have two heads, and interesting. This takes Vagina Dentata to a whole new level, and I'm pretty excited about that, because even though I'm not a huge fan of Vagina Dentata movies and books and stuff, it's, I don't know, it seems tired to me. It's not exciting or scary in any way, shape, or form, but those ways and shapes and forms of horns and tentacles make Vagina Dentata suddenly very interesting. And this is one that I've had my eye on for months, it seems. I love the cover, I like the idea. This is Tidepool by Nicole Willson. This comes from Parliament House Press, and it is out in a week and a bit, maybe 2 weeks. In 1913, Henry Hamilton disappears while on a business trip. His sister, Sorrow, won't rest until she finds out what happened to him. Defying her father's orders to remain at home, she travels to Tidepool, the last place Henry is known to have visited. When Sorrow uncovers the town's deadly secret, its residents, human and otherwise, are hell-bent on making sure she never leaves. I have this feeling of it being something like a Wicker Man twist, you know, with this girl, Sorrow, coming to a place with the most beautiful name of Tidepool, and the cover makes it seem to me it's even more gothic than gothic, and with a girl named Sorrow, I think that this will be one for me. Next up we have Sometimes We're Cruel and Other Stories by J.A.W. McCarthy. This is from Cemetery Gates Media, and it's out soon. Obsession, selfishness, cruelty, doppelgangers. In these dark speculative stories, six reprints and six never before published, including the novelette Girls Tied to Trees, McCarthy explores how far humans and the not quite human will go to tame the darkness in their world and within themselves. This is interesting. I like single author collections very much. I myself have made a few, and I do like them because it gives you that really good feel for the short stories instead of stumbling over one banger in a huge anthology. Although that's the way I found Stephen Graham Jones by reading Father, Son, and Holy Rabbit. That like turned me on to him entirely. But it's rare when you stumble upon one story that that author sticks with you like that. A whole collection. Maybe it's a gamble, but yeah, sounds like one worth taking. All the Tommies in the World by Javier Gombinsky, and this has been getting a bit of buzz lately, and it's out from Pigfarm Press, which is a press I can get behind, and it is out soon. Two jaded horror YouTubers must reunite when a zombie apocalypse hits, unlike anything they expected. Set in a gothic reimagining of Argentina's neighborhood and cemetery of Charquita, built during the yellow fever epidemic of 1871. So, it's a zombie pandemic, it's a zombie apocalypse, sure, but it has threads of pandemia. Is that a word? I don't know if that's a word, but pandemic stuff. So that is the list of books coming out for late July, early August. I hope there's something that's interesting to you in that, because there's quite a few to me. I think that the writers that were working over the last year are going to be getting their wiggles out as far as so many pandemic style stories are going to be hitting. So expect more of that. But I've noticed another trend as well, where it seems to be these cult stories are coming out, and hopefully there's more of them, because I have this theory. On one hand, you can write about pandemics to reflect where we are as a society over the past almost 2 years, or it's the feelings of isolation and being fed misinformation. The other interpretation of that could be cult life, and all these cult books and movies that are coming out could be a reaction to that. I'm always very interested to see what in history precipitated the horror that was being written. I'm no expert on it, but it's neat to see it happening live before us. But yeah, if there's anything there that you're going to be adding to your shelves, or that you've read already, especially, let me know in the comments below, and have an ooky, spooky day.